But it's not all pomp and pageantry, as some groups see the coronation as an opportunity to amplify calls to end the monarchy. Ron Cruz reports.
When King Charles is crowned in a lavish ceremony this weekend, Britain's main anti-monarchist movement will gather along the procession route for a peaceful protest while chanting, "Not my king." Supporters of Republic, a group founded in 1983 that campaigns for an elected head of state, believe Charles's accession to the throne presents their best chance of ending the monarchy. Polls show Charles is less popular than his mother, Queen Elizabeth, the world's second longest reigning monarch.
I think the monarchy's in a lot of trouble because they've lost their star player. Support is clearly going down. Interest is going down, and that's a big problem for them.
Republic's head Graham Smith believes the institution has no place in a 21st century democracy when people are facing the worst cost of living crisis in decades. But polls show majority of Britons still want a royal family. Support for the monarchy, though, is slipping. A decade ago, about 75% of the public backed it, but that figure is now down to 58%.
The big difference isn't so much Charles himself, but the fact that he's not the Queen, and the Queen was the monarchy for so many people, and they were willing to suspend disbelief and to suspend judgment. And they, now that she's not there, she's no longer there to protect the monarchy. And we're seeing an immediate drop in support and a distinct lack of interest in the big ceremonial, which is all they've got.
But a senior lecturer in British politics at the University of Edinburgh believes the monarchy will continue.
I think even close monarchy watchers were surprised about the scale of outpouring of grief when Elizabeth II died in September 2022. And so it showed that there were people from all walks of life that felt some connection, at least to the Queen, the late Queen herself, maybe not the monarchy, but to the Queen herself. So I think probably, while that is not necessarily axiomatically forwarded to her son, Charles III, it still reflects, I think, probably the underlying respect and conditional thinking towards the monarchy, which, short of a realistic alternative, is likely to carry on, namely the monarchy.
Others believe there's no place for hereditary principle in today's Britain, the idea that the throne passes from one member of a ruling family to another member. But a royal historian at the University of Southampton has this to say.
But I think all of this would still be part of our history and story and image identity if they had a much reduced role or if they weren't there at all. I think, you know, we would still go to Buckingham Palace and remember and think. But I don't think they have a place in modern Britain.
Continuity. Princess Anne, sister of King Charles, meanwhile defends the relevance of the monarchy.
It is the monarch that is the key to this, and the constitution that underpins the monarchy. We as a family see ourselves there as to support that that role, which means that what we do, we hope, contributes to the monarchy and the way in which it can convey continuity of not just interest, but of service, of understanding, the way that people and communities want to live their lives.
King Charles is set to be crowned on May 6.
The U.S. Federal Reserve hikes its benchmark policy rate for the 10th straight time, but hints at a pause in the tightening cycle. In its policy statement, the Fed dropped a line from its March guidance that it anticipated additional policy firming may be appropriate. Instead, it would take into account the effects of the recent hikes as well as future economic data. Although Fed Chair Jerome Powell said policymakers still view inflation as too high, and it was too soon to say the rate hike cycle is over.
We are prepared to do more if greater monetary policy restraint is warranted. We remain committed to bringing inflation back down to our 2% goal and to keep our longer-term inflation expectations well anchored. Reducing inflation is likely to require a period of below-trend growth and some softening of labor market conditions.
The Fed increased interest rates by a quarter of a percentage point as expected, bringing its benchmark overnight interest rate to 5% to 5.25% range. Russia accuses Ukraine of attempting to assassinate Russian President Vladimir Putin. Russia's presidential press service said two drones had been used in the alleged attack on Putin's Kremlin residence. But Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky denied his country carried out the alleged attack. As for the United States, its State Department cannot confirm whether Russia is telling the truth.
We are aware of these reports, but unable to confirm the authenticity of this. But also, as the Secretary said, I would take anything coming from the Kremlin and the Russian Federation with a shaker of salt. But throughout this, it's important to remember a couple things, Nick. First, Russia invaded Ukraine. It did so unprovoked. They started this war, and they could end it today if they pulled their troops out. Number two, Russia continues to fire missiles and drones at Ukraine every week. And they have done so and targeted scores of Ukrainians, including children. And they have been targeted places like hospitals, apartment buildings. And we have been very clear that we're going to continue to support Ukraine as it defends itself from Russia's invasion.
Another batch of Filipino evacuated from conflict-hit Sudan arrived home. The latest batch is comprised of 17 Filipinos, raising the total number of repatriates to 106. The Foreign Affairs Department says 661 out of the 750 Filipinos were evacuated from Khartoum. Nearly 400 evacuees in Cairo, in Egypt, are still waiting for their repatriation flights. Psychosocial interventions are immediately provided to those who arrive home.
Ang financial assistance po na ibibigay natin ngayon ay sa 50,000 to the DMW at mayroon din pong similar amount sa region po at ito naman yung magagaling po sa atin sa OWA.
A Filipino who escaped the violence in Sudan describes the dire situation in the conflict-torn country. Norad Langila said, aside from trying not to get caught in the crossfire, they also had to evade looters who targeted evacuees.
Grupo-grupo sila, may 10 tao ganyan, hinukubkub nila yung isang sasakyan. Tapos pag may lalapit na kasama yung ibang mga tao, parang sinusunggaban nila na ibig sabihin, huwag kang lumapit, eh, sa amin na to. Mm-hmm. Parang ganun. Mm-hmm. Doon ako natakot kasi napuno ang kalsada dahil sa kanila. Tapos sabi ko sa mga kasamahan ko, kasi lahat kami estudyante, sabi ko sa kanila, i-close nyo yung bintana lahat. Yung bintana, may ano kasi siya, parang may dingding siya na tela. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko, i-close nyo, huwag kayong sumilip. Sabi ko, kasi pag makita tayo ngayon ng mga foreigner tayo, baka harangin nila yung bus natin, tapos pasukin nila tayo, kunin na mga gamit natin.